Hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR by Info. In previous classes we have discussed the differences between the prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell and also differences between the plant and animal cell. Next to that we have discussed plasma membrane. Is it right? In the present we have going to discuss an important topic, that is a cell wall of plant cell. Cell wall. Actually, we know very well when we have discussed in the differences between the plant cell and animal cell, and have mentioned the plant cells that contains the outer membrane, that is a cell wall. Whereas these outer membrane, that is not present in the animal cell. Is it right? So let us see, actually not only plants. The cell wall which is present in the bacteria, present in the fungi, and also in the plants. So the bacteria that contains cell wall in the form of peptidoglycan, these peptidoglycan, which is made up of two monomers of polysaccharide, that is NAC and NAM. NAC meant for the N-acetyl glucosamine, whereas NAM, which is denotes the N-acetyl muramic acid. So, this is the NAM and NAC are the monomers, simply called as a saccharides. These saccharides which are present in the cell wall in the alternative form NAC-NAM, NAC-NAM, NAC-NAM like that, and forms the matrix of structure in the cell wall of bacteria. That is called as a bacteria cell wall. Actually, based on the cell wall, the bacteria can divide into two types. One is a gram positive, second one is a gram negative. The gram positive bacteria that contains a plasma membrane, above the plasma membrane, a thick layer of cell wall is present. Thick layer. This is all about the gram positive bacteria that contains the cell wall on outside. Coming to the gram negative bacteria, here is one important and interesting concept. The gram negative bacteria that contains the plasma membrane, above the plasma membrane, a thin layer of peptidoglycan is present. Very thin layer. Is it right? Above this thin layer of cell wall, there is another plasma membrane is present. Above this plasma membrane, again it contains a very thin layer of peptidoglycan layer. In this way, the gram negative bacteria, which contains the two plasma membranes, which is separated by the thin layer of peptidoglycan. So this is a very important. The two plasma membranes contained cell is the gram negative bacteria, which is separated by the cell wall. These cell walls, which are made up of with NAG and NAM, that is a clear indication. Okay, coming to the fungi. Fungi also contains the cell wall. This cell wall is made up of with the NAG. The polymer of NAG. NAG means N-acetyl glucosamine. Coming to the plants. The plants, actually it is a very complex structure when compared with the fungi and bacteria. Because the plants that contain the cellulose as a cell wall membrane structure, and also it contains the hemicellulose, It also having the pectin and lignin. All these are the components which are present in the cell wall of plants. In today's class, we are going to see detailed manner regarding to the plant cell wall in respect of the fungi and the bacteria. Is it clear? So, let us start with the cell wall. Okay, the cell wall of plant actually which is made up of these components. We have to know about the little bit about composition of the cellulose and hemicellulose, pectin and lignin, and simply their functions also. Let us start with the cellulose. Cellulose are glucose monomers are combined together forms the polysaccharide. That polysaccharide is bind by the beta 1,2,4 glycosidic bonds. And these beta 1,2 glycosidic bonds of a chain 1 present in these, and also this chain combined with the another chain or adjacent chain with the non-covalent bonds. In between these, there is a non-covalent bonds are present. So, many types of chains which are polysaccharides combined together, they form the a structure, a fibril structure that is called as a glucose fibril or cellulose fibril. The cellulose fibril which connected with the non-covalent bonds. So this is all about the cellulose. If the plant cell wall that contains the huge amount of cellulose, that is very rigid in nature. Very rigid in nature. If the content of the cellulose is very less, then the cell wall of the plant or any one that contains a very thin and very flexible in nature. So this is a major important function of this cellulose. The cellulose actually it is a non-dissolved in water and also which is resist to the enzymes and also chemicals. Which is resist, it means which cannot digested by the enzymes and also chemicals. Which is secreted by a complex structure of plasma membrane and cellulose synthase. Plasma membrane complex cellulose synthase. So, this is all about the cellulose. Coming to the hemicellulose pectins, actually these are the two components of cell wall which forms the matrix of cell wall. The matrix, it means you can see this is called as the components of cell wall. These components are very cross-linked with the one another that forms the matrix structure. So this type of matrix structure is done by the hemicellulose and pectin. In the matrix of these structures, the cellulose and also pectin, lignin and other chemicals and also some important proteins also present and dipped into this matrix of cell wall of plant. See, let us start with the hemicellulose. So, hemicellulose is a heterogeneous polysaccharide which is heterogeneous polysaccharide which is made up with the xylan, a monomer of sugar, and also glucomannan, xylan and glucomannan. Hemicellulose actually which forms the matrix structure. So this is all about the hemicellulose. Coming to the pectin. Pectin is a polysaccharide. This pectin also made up with the galactouronine is a component or sugar that is forms the polymers complex called as a pectin. This pectin also present in the matrix. Is it clear? Actually, this pectin has so many functions. The pectin, which is essential for the maintenance of pH of cell wall, and also it maintains the ionic balance across the cell wall and plasma membrane and cell, and it prevents the pathogenic entry into the cell due to the presence of many cross links. So these are the functions which are regarding to the pectin. Coming to the one more important component, that is the lignin. Lignin also polyphenolic compound, which is made up of the three alcohol subunits. It's a polysaccharide. It is a polymer actually. It is made up of the three alcohols. One includes coniferol alcohol. Second is the coumaryl alcohol. The third one is a sinopyl alcohol. See here, the lignin is made up of the sinopyl alcohol, coniferol alcohol, coumaryl alcohol. These coumaryl and sinopyl, coniferol all together the forms the very complex structure that is called as a lignin. Actually, lignin that contains very important function. The lignin that replaces the water which is present in the matrix of the hemicellulose and pectin. Due to the replace of the water present in this matrix, the matrix forms into the hydrophobic in nature. This hydrophobic nature which causes the very important function, that is it prevents the entry of pathogenic organism into the inside of cell. And one more point I forgot here regarding to the pectin. The pectin actually forms the gel-like structure. Pectin actually forms the gel-like structure in the cell wall of matrix. So gel-like structure of pectin, which is essential for the poration of the cells. The cell which transport the components from outside to the inside through the pores which are caused by the pectin component of cell. Okay, is it clear? Coming to the lignin. Lignin causes these functions. If the lignin is present in the cell wall, such type of cell wall is a very thick in nature and very rigid in nature. That should be remembered. Okay, all these are the very important components which are present in the cell wall of plant cell. Along with these, there are proteins also present in the cell wall. The proteins also embedded in the matrix of the cell wall. Let us see, the proteins which are present in the cell wall are the majorly proline rich protein, hydroxyproline, rich protein. The third one is glycine rich protein. Glycine rich protein. So here the proteins, we know very well, the proteins are the monomers of amino acids. All monomers of amino acid combined together, they form the peptides, peptides to the polypeptides. Such polypeptides we call as the proteins. Is it right? So these polypeptides are made up of with the proline is a amino acid. If that polypeptide that contains the high number of proline, such type of proteins we called as a proline rich protein. Whereas that protein or polypeptide that contains the hydroxyproline in rich amount, such proteins called as a hydroxyproline rich proteins. Similarly, glycine, if there is a huge number, such proteins called as a glycine rich proteins. So here the proteins which are embedded in the matrix of cell wall are made up of with the either this one or this one. So in this way the proteins are present. Here there are two important proteins which are present in the cell wall of plant. Those two proteins are the extensin and expansin. Extensin and expansin are the proteins which are embedded in the matrix of the cell wall. So extensin is a structural protein. It gives the structure of cell wall. Whereas coming to the expansin, expansin is a functional protein. During the development and growth of the cell wall, the expansion should be taken place. That expansion is caused by the this protein called as a expansin. Actually, what it causes, expansin, which causes the break the non-covalent bonds which are present in between the glucose polysaccharides of cellulose microfibrils. So that is the important function of the expansin and extensin. So this is all about the different components which are present in the cell wall of plant. Okay, let us start with the how cell wall architecture is present in the plant cell. Okay, let us see the architecture. The architecture of cell wall of plant cell. We know very well the plant cell that contains the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is double layer. That plasma membrane is surrounded by the cell wall. Is it right? This is cell wall and this is a plasma membrane. I am going to draw this part here. How it looks? Let us see. This is plasma membrane. Okay, this is plasma membrane. During the development of cell, this plasma membrane which produces a thin layer of cell wall on surface of plasma membrane. What happened? Thin layer of cell wall is produced here. Such type of cell wall is made up of with a component called as cellulose, 25%, hemicellulose, 25%, and pectin, 35%, and plus other things are the rest of percent. So the cell that producing the cell wall at the initial stage of cell growth, such cell wall called as a primary cell wall. Primary cell wall. So after expansion or after growth and after growth retardation, if the cell cannot going to the develop and cell cannot going to be growth, then these cell can retard their growth. At that time, the cell that produces the another layer of cell wall, another layer of cell wall onto the plasma membrane. Let us see here. What will happen? This is plasma membrane. This plasma membrane actually is very adjacent to the primary cell wall. But during cell growth, this happens. After cell growth, the cell retard their growth. Then it produces the one more layer of cell wall. Third cell wall we called as a secondary cell wall. Third secondary cell wall present onto the plasma membrane, where the primary cell wall get move outside of the cell. Let us see. So in this way it forms, this is the plasma membrane, this is the secondary cell wall. This cell wall, this is the plasma membrane. Above the secondary cell wall, there is the primary cell wall. You can observe the differences between the secondary cell wall and primary cell wall. The secondary cell wall is a very thick in nature when compared to the primary cell wall. Whereas, see, what are the components which are present in the secondary cell wall? Secondary cell wall that contains the cellulose at the 35%. 35% of the cellulose plus 25% of the hemicellulose. And next hemicellulose, the huge amount of this secondary cell wall contains the lignin, the rest of the part, and also that contains a small amount of the proteins. See here, what happened? The cellulose and lignins, these are the very rigid in nature. They are forms very many number of cross links that forms the very tensile resistance to the cell wall. It gives the very tensile resistance. It gives very tensile rigidity to the cell wall. So I mentioned already that if the pectin is present, the type of cell wall is a very flexible. If the cell wall that contains the lignin or cellulose, such type of cell walls are very rigid in nature. Here, after growing completed of cell, the cell produces the secondary cell wall is a very thick, and also that contains a very rigid in nature due to the presence of cellulose in high amount and also lignin is high amount. So in this way it forms the secondary cell wall and primary cell wall. After that, one more component of cell wall is the middle lamella. One more component of cell wall is the middle lamella. Middle lamella is a component of cell wall. But this component of cell wall is made up of with the pectin. Very, very important point. Actually, it was asked in the previous NEET exam. So, pectin, the middle lamella, which is made up of with the pectin, especially calcium pectate. Calcium pectate is a component which is present in the pectin, such type of calcium pectate which forms the outer layer of cell wall, that is the middle lamella. See here, the middle lamella which is present in between the two adjacent cells of plant. Two adjacent cells. For example, if you take, this is the one type of cell that contains the plasma membrane, secondary layer, primary layer, and middle lamella. Then the adjacent cell also that contains the here layer, that is the primary layer. Again, that contains the secondary layer. Again, that contains the plasma membrane. So in this way, so here to here, this part called as cell 1 and this part called as a cell 2. These two cells are adjacent to each other through the layer called as a middle lamella. So this is a very important. Middle lamella is a, they connecting two cells. Though they connecting two cells, it is a part of the cell wall. So in this way, entire cell wall of plant cell that consists of different architecture in the manner and different composition. So what we have to understand here, the microfibrils of cellulose, the microfibrils of cellulose and also proteins which are embedded in the matrix of the hemicellulose and pectin. Let us see the diagram. If you draw this, for example, it is a hemicellulose. This hemicellulose is cross-linked and matrixed by the pectin. These are the very thin in nature, you can observe it. This is called as a pectin. This is all about the matrix, right? The matrix that embedded with the what actually cellulose microfibrils. The cellular microfibrils are the very large in nature. So they form the in this structure in the matrix. Along with that, that matrix also contains the some proteins. So in this way, what actually having the this is plasma membrane. The plasma membrane, on the plasma membrane, there is a matrix that is caused by the two components such as hemicellulose and pectin. Is it right? In this matrix, the proteins are embedded. Those proteins are, we already mentioned, that is expansion and extension. And also the cellulose fibrils which are present and which are also dipped inside of the matrix. So in this way, complete architecture of cell wall of plant cell can occur. So this is all about the cell wall. In this, we have to understand, we have to remember, only thing is the components which are present in the each part of the cell wall. There are layers. Primary cell wall contains a huge number of what type of components. If the question may ask, the primary cell wall contains cellulose, hemicellulose, pectin and lignin. Here the lignin is absent in the primary cell wall. Coming to the one more question, what are the components which are present in the secondary cell wall? The secondary cell wall actually that contains the what? Cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. Where if the answer is the pectin, if the option is the pectin, that pectin is a wrong one, because the pectin which is not present in the huge amount of secondary plasma membrane, cell wall. Whereas coming to the middle lamella, the middle lamella which contains only pectin, is it right? If the pectin is present, that layer, whatever the layer, that is a very flexible. If the lignin or cellulose contents are very high, such type of layers causes a very rigid image. This is all about the overview regarding to the cell wall of plant. Is it clear? I hope this class is very clear to understand. Also remember, I given much information regarding cell wall of plant. So if you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to like, share and comment. Thank you.